Over here, but also I can get really artsy with them. Like this one here has a raven's head carved at the bottom with onyx eyes and this detailed white raven fetish. And just love that I found a way that I can be my artistic self and my musical self and combine the two and make a living at it. So it's been 20, close to 25 years now. And flutes have helped me buy a house and raise my kids, and it's all that I've done since I was a kid. And I'm proud to say I've only punched into a clock 10 months of my life ever. I don't even think they do that anymore, though, do they? And so I'll demonstrate some of these flutes here, and this little guy here, I do not make these, but this is a... called a rav drum. It was invented probably only about 5 years ago in Russia. And Remyanikov is his name that made these. And it was inspired from a drum called a hong drum. That was invented about year 2000. And that was inspired from Trinidadian steel drums. These hand hammered notes, but somebody had asked this steel maker if he could create a steel drum that was convex that you could play. And so this hong drum was invented. And they had the patent on that until about 05, 07, somewhere like that, the company Pan Art. And they released the patent, and now they still have a patent on the name hong drum. They call them hand pans, and there's makers, probably 100, 150 in the world. There's new people coming all the time, probably 30 to 50 really good makers. Beautiful instrument. I love using the little looper and incorporating it with the flutes. And so I'll try that out. Mm-hmm. Anyway, there's another friend of mine who makes flute. Does anybody have any questions or anything for me? I only have about 4 minutes here.
Do you have like iTunes or SoundCloud?
I have a Bandcamp account.
Okay.
You'd have to just look up Miguel Medina. I think I'm booth 17, Singing Tree. Please come talk to me afterwards.
Oh, okay.
I got a newsletter that shows different performances and things you can get on that. Real quick, I'll just demonstrate another one. So one day, a long time ago, some guy who made flutes also did a lot of native ceremonies and introduced me to both, which I still do both today. He gave me a stick and said, put the holes here, 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 and here, and it'll sound pretty good. And so then it took me 8 or so years to fiddle around with tuning to with a tuner and 440 hertz and all these things and discovering and destroying tons of wood, figuring out how to make different flutes in different keys. Now I make them anywhere from a little high G to an ultra bass low flute that you have to play like this. There's a couple big ones over there. But yeah, it's fun. Also different tunings, Arabian